So much has happened in 2021, not just for cloud computing, but in general, of course. Now, this being the last show of the year, it's time for the Azure This Year Awards. So sit tight, grab the popcorn, and enjoy. Welcome to the end of the year awards for Azure, or what we like to call the Cronenbergs. Now, these might not be the awards that you expect, but they are the ones that you deserve. And let's not dilly-dally and drag out the time like on all those other award shows. We're digging in now. The first Cronenberg of the evening is for the most underrated Azure service of the year. And the nominees are Azure Storage for its continued improvement and addition of new features you never knew you wanted or needed. Immutable tags, client-side encryption, and index tags are a few of the new features that you probably didn't know existed. Azure App Configuration for being able to centrally manage application settings and feature flags, as well as debug environments fast and efficiently. Event Grid for its versatility and applicability, that's a hard word to say, in a ton of scenarios, including checking claims between services, pushing millions of events to a large number of services, and checking any number of properties in a system. And the winner is Event Grid. Yeah, really, that wasn't a hard choice. Congratulations, Event Grid. Now, if you want to know more about the hidden gems and underrated servers in Azure, check out the blog post I wrote a couple of weeks ago on just that topic. Link is in the description. And we go from hidden services to not so hidden events. 2021 brought a few whoopsies in the cloud, and we think they should be remembered. So the nominees are the Azure AD outage in March, where pretty much all of Azure login and authentication went offline for 2 or more hours. The August Cosmos DB incident that exposed over 3,000 customers' data to, well, everyone. And the Cronenberg goes to AWS for this week's trouble that took Amazon.com, Netflix, Disney+, Venmo, and many more. So well done, AWS.
Ouch!
Now, if you want to know what really happened in more detail on AWS, head over to our sister show, AWS This Week. So let's get to the hands-on award of the year, the best new or updated tool. And there are so many tools on Azure, of which some are excellent, some not so much. The nominees are Azure Virtual Desktop for allowing everyone to work from home on a managed environment that doesn't require any installation or software. Azure SQL Database Ledger for providing cryptographic evidence that centralized data stores haven't been tampered with. And Azure Arc for allowing VM containers and SQL databases anywhere to be managed through Azure. And finally, Visual Studio Code for allowing everyone to be a developer, even if you have a Chromebook. Yes. And the winner of the Cronenberg is Visual Studio Code for now being 100% online and accessible through your browser. Just a fantastic tool for any developer, cloud or not. Well done, Visual Studio Code. Now we're getting to the pointy end of the evening. The next two awards have been at the top of the cloud computing mantelpiece of several services. The first award is the best serverless service of the year. And the nominees are Azure Functions for providing the easiest way to pretend there are no servers in the cloud. Azure Functions for enabling complex architectures with decoupled and distributed projects, and Azure Functions for enabling thousands of developers to create fast and efficient solutions to real business problems. And the Cronenberg goes to Azure Logic Apps for continuing to surprise everyone with the powerful integrations of hundreds of services with little effort and amazing value. Congratulations, Logic Apps. One of the things that Azure does, very well, apart from giving us infinite compute, is testing our knowledge on the cloud itself. After all, having a certification shows that you understand the subject and that you are taking your cloud journey seriously. So the nominees for Best Azure Certification Exam are AZ305 Azure Solutions Architect Expert. This certificate is finally consolidating all of the goodness of Azure architecture into a single exam. Still bloody hard though. AZ700 for recognizing networking in the cloud is what binds all of Azure together. and AZ800 and 801 for finally looking after the huge on-prem segment that looks to using Azure in a hybrid capacity. Whew, it's a big one. Really big, actually. And the winner is all of the certifications, as they all help our learners succeed in the cloud and make a better career for them. So well done on certifications. That's it for 2021. I'll be back in the new year with a whole lot more Azure, and who knows, perhaps even a new co-host or two. Thanks for now. Enjoy the time with your family and loved ones. Keep being awesome. And I can't actually stretch my arms more than this. That's why I don't. But anyway.